Ever wanted to know how to use Ray MMD to achieve tune-like render in MMD? In this video, I'll show you how to configure Ray MMD to achieve that amazing tune-like render. By the end of this tutorial, you'll have the skills to make the most of Ray MMD's tune-based shading. Before we begin setting up Ray MMD, make sure you have Miku Miku Effects or MME installed in your MMD. If you don't have it, don't worry. We've provided a download link and installation instructions in the description below. You'll also need to download the latest version of Ray MMD. Head over to www.github.com/ray-cast/ray-mmd/releases and download the zip file for version 1.5.2. Once downloaded, extract the contents of the zip file to a folder of your choice. Next, download the tune materials that we will use in this tutorial. Once downloaded, extract the contents of the zip file and place its tune folder inside Ray MMD's materials folder. Additionally, download the three MMD effects that we will use to enhance the appearance of our render. Lastly, download the model and stage that we will be using in this tutorial so you can follow along. Download link is in the description as well. Now let's get started. Before opening MMD, you need to make some changes in Ray MMD. First, make a copy of your Ray MMD folder and name it Ray MMD 1.5.2 Tune. Go to your Ray MMD Tune folder and open the ray.config file using Notepad or any text editor of your choice. Scroll down and search for outline quality, then change its value to 3. This will enable the Outline Map tab in MME. Enable Tune Materials by changing the value of Tune Enabled to 2. Lastly, disable Screen Space Subsurface Scattering by changing the value of SSSS Quality to 0. Save the changes by going to File and clicking on Save. Now let's change the default material that you are going to use. In your Ray MMD Tune folder, go to the Materials folder and double-click Material 2.0.fx. Press Ctrl plus F to type Custom in the pop-up that appears, and then press the Find Next button. It will highlight Custom Enable. Change its value to 9 for tune-based shading. Next, scroll down and search for Custom A, and change its value to 0.75. Finally, change the value of Custom B to 0.5. These two parameters are used to adjust the shadow roughness and brightness. You can play around with these values later after finishing this tutorial. Save the changes by going to File and clicking on Save. Now that we've finished editing the files in Ray MMD, let's continue and do the basic setup inside MMD. First, let's make some quick view and lighting adjustments so we can see what we're doing clearly. Go to View and deselect Display Coordinate Axis, Display Ground Shadow, and Transparent Ground Shadow. Next, go to Light Manipulation and set X to 0.2, Y to negative 0.4, and Z to 0.4. Click Register to save the changes. Now, let's load all the files we're going to use in order. First, load the skybox from Ray MMD by going to Model Manipulation, clicking Load, navigating to your Ray MMD folder, opening the skybox folder, selecting Sky Hemisphere, and clicking Sky with Box.pmx. Second, load the Ray Controller by returning to your Ray MMD folder and clicking RayController.pmx. Third, click to Camera, go to Accessory Manipulation, click Load. Navigate to your Ray MMD folder and select Ray.x. Please be patient as it may take a little time to load Ray.x. Next, load the model by going to Model Manipulation, clicking Load, navigating to your Models folder, and select Black.pmx. Let's change the position of the model's eye highlights by going to Facial Manipulation, and set null 227 and null 228 to 1. Click Register for each change. Adjust the thickness of the model's edges by going to View and selecting Thickness of Edge Line. Set its value to 2. Lastly, load the stage we're going to use by following the same steps you used to load the model. Change the position of the stage by going to the Bone Place section and changing the Y value to -92.75 and Z to 12.15. Click Register. Now that we've loaded all the necessary files, let's configure Ray MMD in MME. Click on MME located in the upper right corner, then select Effect Mapping. On the Main tab, double-click the model. Navigate to your Ray MMD folder, click the main folder, and select main.fx. Do the same step and apply main.fx to the stage as well. Finally, go to the Outline Map tab. Select both the model and stage, right-click and click Set Effect. Go to Ray MMD's Outline folder, then to the Fixed Color X1 folder, and select Outline Black.fx. Click Apply and then OK to save the changes. You have now completed the basic setup for Ray MMD Tune Shader Mode. Let's proceed to the next step by changing the model's materials to make it look better.
For materials.
In this section, let's make some changes to the model's texture using Tune Materials. If you want a more detailed explanation on how to change the texture of the model, you can check my basic Ray MMD tutorial for beginners. The link is provided in the description below. Now go to MME, click Effect Mapping, and in the Material Map tab, right-click the model and select Subset Extract. As you can see, the model's material is split into parts. First, double-click the material for the model's face, which is Subset 0. Navigate to your Ray MMD Tune Folder's Materials folder, then to the Tune folder and select ToonFace2.fx. Second, double-click the material for the model's white eyes, which is Subset 2. Go to your Tune folder again and select ToonWhiteEye.fx. Third, double-click the material for the model's iris, which is Subset 3. Once more, go to your Tune folder and select ToonEye.fx. Fourth, let's make the eyes highlights glow by selecting Subset 4. In your Ray MMD's Materials folder, double-click on the Emissive folder, then go to the Fixed Color X1 folder and select Material Albedo X1.fx. Fifth, double-click the material for the model's body, which is Subset 5. Navigate to your Tune folder and select ToonSkin 416.fx. Sixth, double-click the material for the model's hair, which is Subset 6. Again, in the Tune folder, select ToonHairYamakaze.fx. Seventh, let's change the clothes material. Double-click Subset 8. Navigate to your Tune folder and select Tune.fx. To make the blue lights on the model glow, double-click Subset 12. Go to your Ray MMD Tunes Materials folder, double-click on the Emissive folder, then to the Fixed Color X4 folder, and select Material Albedo X4.fx. Lastly, let's make the pink lights glow. Select Subset 13. Go to the Emissive folder once more, then to the Fixed Color X2 folder, and select Material Albedo X2.fx. Click Apply and then OK to save the changes. You have now changed the model's materials into Tune Materials, but it looks bland. In the next part, we will configure the Ray controller and add more effects to make it look awesome. Now let's make some changes in the Ray controller. Go to the Model Manipulation section and select the Ray controller. First, in the Facial Manipulation section, change Sunlight Plus to 0.1 and click Register. Next, select SSDO Plus and set its value to 0.6. Click Register. Then go to Bloom Threshold Plus and change it to 0.6. Click Register. After that, go to Saturation Plus and change it to 0.2. Click Register. Select Gamma Minus and change its value to 0.2 as well. Click Register. Finally, go to Balance B Plus and change it to 0.2, then click Register. Click to camera to see how it looks. Now for the last part of this tutorial, let's enhance the render even further by adding more MMD effects. First, let's make the scene look to a whole new level by adding diffusion. Go to Accessory Manipulation, click on Load, then navigate to the folder where you put your effects. Go to Diffusion 7 folder and double-click Diffusion.x. Next, let's focus the scene on the model by adding Powered Off. Follow the same steps as you did to load Diffusion 7, but this time go to the Powered Off V006 folder and select Powered Off.x. Change the value of its SI to 0.1 and click Register. You can stop here if you are already satisfied with this look, but if you want to give it a more cartoony feel, let's do that by adding the next effect. Go to the Model Manipulation section, click Load, then navigate to the folder where you've placed your effects. Go to the Tune folder, then to the Multi-Edge V025 folder and select MultiEdge.pmd. Now go to File, click Load Motion Data, navigate again to your Effects folder, double-click on the Tune folder, and select MultiEdge.bmd. In the Facial Manipulation, change the value of the mouth parameter to 0.6 and click Register. Click to camera to see how it looks. If you've made it this far, congratulations! You have now successfully learned how to use the Ray MMD tune-based shading. Did you find this tutorial helpful? If so, please take a moment to like and comment on the video. It helps this tutorial reach more people. Do you prefer a more realistic render rather than a tune-like style? Then how about watching this tutorial next?